Community of Ramblers. Once again, folks, all doors and windows on the train should be closed, and no one should be moving between cars at this time, as we are approaching the front. At South Tamaqua, we pass through the coal piles of the Premium Fine Coal Company, a classic anthracite region setting. Very shortly, we will enter another segment of double track railroading.
And we're out.
I'd wait a while before you open my windows.
Such a way that any piece of timber could be removed and repaired without having to stop train traffic from crossing the bridge. In 1896, the wooden bridge was replaced by a steel structure, and in 1931, the Phoenix Bridge Company rebuilt the bridge into its current form. It was originally intended to be a double-track bridge to carry a planned main line running between New York and Chicago. During World War I, owing perhaps to its strategic location, the bridge was guarded by soldiers against trespassers and intruders. During World War II, security guards provided by the railroad watched the bridge around the clock. The last time the bridge was guarded in such a manner was during the 1948 presidential campaign of Harry S. Truman. Truman traveled over 30,000 miles across 28 states, giving over 350 speeches on Knifer Creek. As we go over the bridge, feel free to take all the damn pictures you wish. Now, folks, don't start throwing things. You might hit me. Anyway, to give you a little history of the Hometown High Bridge, the first incarnation of the bridge was completed in 1870 when this line was first built. It was made entirely of wooden timbers. The threat of fire caused by the hot coals and sparks from steam locomotives was a constant problem. To safeguard against this, two watchmen were employed to inspect the bridge following February of 2020, and allows the Reading and Northern Railroad a progressive move between North Reading and key points north such as Penobscot, Pittston, and Tunkhannock.
Now that I'm thinking about it, though, now I'm thinking about how it's going to be a catch-up. We should do it right here.
buildings of what will become our Nesquehoning campus. This location is ideally situated right in the middle of our main line between North Reading and Pittsburgh. Nesquehoning itself was founded in 1830 by the Apollo Navigation Company to provide housing for the employees mining anthracite in the nearby Grim Run mine. The tracks pass directly through a residential neighborhood.
Nice town.
Gentlemen, we are approaching the station at Jim Thorpe, and as many of you have been wondering, that will be the site of our special photo run-by on today's trip. If you wish to participate in the photo run-by, please be sure to turn our other steam locomotive, number 425, that is used on passenger excursions. Today, the 2102 will use the Y at Nesquehoning, River and Jim Thorpe junctions to turn before returning to the yard just west of the station. While the 2102 is sitting in the yard, we encourage you to stop by, meet our fantastic steam crew, and take as many photographs as you wish. Deeper into the yard, we pass over Pennsylvania Route 903, Jim Thorpe's memorial. Thank you.
around 2 o'clock.
To the crossing. Crossing's clear, 2013.
8 clear.
Now.